Hey, horsey and gum people. I got two more meals from this home chef. I can't believe the number of people that asked me, what's the name of the place? Come on, people, pay attention. So I got sirloin steak, red wine, Marcello Bordelaise. I don't know what the hell that is. Looks good. And then I have hot honey glazed chicken. Ooh. So these two things came in, gives you the two worksheets. And this one, I have all my ingredients for my steak, which I'm going to make here. Here's my two steaks that came in. And there is the chicken that came in. So I'm going to cook the steak. And this, here's the other thing for making the chicken, the bell pepper. It looks like I got some fresh garlic. Got some broccoli. I don't know what else. I'll go over the ingredients when I cook that one. But I'm going to do the steak now. Well, this little meal came with kind of a lot of little ingredients here. I got some spinach. Looks like I got some Parmesan cheese. I got some polenta. I got some demi-glace. Somebody told me how to pronounce it, but I forgot. This looks like some red wine. It doesn't say what's on it, but I'm assuming. Some mushrooms. A little package of plain light cream cheese. Crumbled bacon. Look at that bacon. That looks pretty good. This looks like maybe some garlic butter. I don't know what that is. Does it say on there? I don't know what that is. And then my sirloin steak. So let's get cooking. Okay, so the directions aren't real clear here. It says cut mushrooms coarsely, half butter. What the hell does that mean? I don't see butter. Is this butter? Is this the garlic butter? I'm assuming this is. And does that mean cut it in half or... Not good instructions. If anybody wants to give these companies a thing, this is what they need to do. Every ingredient need to be numbered. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then when you use those ingredients, it should be right up here. Use 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. So you don't miss ingredients and it makes it simpler to find. But anyway, so I chopped up my mushrooms, chopped up my spinach. Spinach is going to go in a polenta. And then I dried my, patted dry my meat and then salt and peppered it on both sides. And now we're moving on to cooking the polenta. Okay, so we got this heat. They said, what is that? A teaspoon of olive oil. Yeah, that looks about like a teaspoon. Maybe a little more. And they said heat it up over a medium thing and then add my bacon. So I'm going to crisp up the bacon here. Bacon comes out. And a little stirrer. And we're supposed to crisp up the bacon. That bacon looks a little mild. Probably needs a little crushed red pepper. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Looks better already. Okay, so this is going to be the polenta. And we're going to... I wonder if this light helps. Oh, I can't. My microwave broke. Everything's breaking on me. Microwave broke. What else broke? I got all kinds of things broken. My speaker went out on my TV. All right. So let's see what we got here. So we're crisping up the bacon. Now we're going to add 2 1/4 cups of water, bring to a simmer, and then stir in the polenta. So I really haven't opened the polenta yet, so I should probably open the polenta. I'll be back. Okay, so it looks like this is pretty much done. I'm okay with that. So we're going to add the water in. 2 3/4 cups. Bring that to a simmer. Luckily that fits, or I'd be like changing pots. So, I'm going to add the polenta and then the cream cheese. What else? Am I missing a step? Someone will be pointing out. You missed that step. Okay. Bring to simmer. Lower the heat. Add softened cream cheese, spinach, and half the Parmesan. Oh, I got to cut my Parmesan open too. All right. So I need to cut that open. This one-handed filming is just kind of... All right. So my Parmesan's open. I'll be putting half of that in there. All right, so polenta, cream cheese, parmesan, a little salt and pepper, constantly stirring. Okay, so first we have to bring this up to a little steam, and I will put a little salt in there. I can't because I have to twist it, so it's two-handed. All right, I'll be back when I add the polenta. Okay, so that's the cream cheese and the butter in there. Man, it thickened up, made it nice and creamy. Man, it smells pretty good too. So now I'm gonna add my spinach. I gotta keep stirring this because when it gets thick, it'll start popping as it's starting to boil. So you don't want it popping and splattering. So all I did was pour in the polenta. Now I need to add my spinach, the butter, half the Parmesan, and half, that's half the butter. All right, so I turned down the heat a little bit, and that looks like it's thickening up nice. Polenta, sometimes I've had it and it was good. Sometimes I've had it and it's not so good. So we'll see how this is. All right, gotta add my spinach, Parmesan, and butter, and cream cheese. Okay, so that's the cream cheese and the butter in there. Man, it thickened up, made it nice and creamy. Man, it smells pretty good too. So now I'm gonna add my spinach. Okay, spinach is added. Put half the Parmesan in now. Gonna stir that in. Alrighty. I think my polenta's done. So I need to put this to the side. I don't know if I need to keep cooking it or just warm it up. But it looks pretty good. All right, get those steaks on there and see what we got going on next. Okay, so polenta's done. Now I gotta get the steaks in here. And we will cook them about, I don't know, 5 minutes or so on each side. And then the mushrooms and the rest of the sauce is going to be the sauce. Okay, so the meat's done. And the mushrooms are kind of simmering for a few minutes here. And then I'm going to add the glaze and some wine that I spilt. They said you only use half the wine. So since I spilt some, I should be able to use all the wine. So these are kind of, I forgot what the term is, not condensing down, but whatever, they're getting soft and they're kind of like cooking. So I'm supposed to cook those for 3 or 4 minutes and then add the wine, half the red wine, throw the rest away. So these are almost done. All right, let's get some wine in there. Maybe let me spread these out nice and flat so we're getting good cooking down. Man, they sure do smell good. Now all I did before the faux mushroom is I add a little bit more olive oil, and then what was ever left for me cooking the steaks, I'll add the oil or the wine. That looks about half. You don't want to add too much wine. That condensed down. Oh, that's kind of, that made the kitchen smell real nice. Let me tell you that. Ooh, doggies. That smells good. And then after I add the wine, put the glaze in there. And I forgot what this glaze, whatever. I guess that just thickens it up. Whew. That looks like some good juices. I'm going to put the rest of the butter in there after I pull this down a little bit. The pan isn't real good for flipping that around, but we're gonna let that cook down for, I don't know, I just want it to kind of thicken up. What does it say? Add the mushrooms, 3-4 minutes, add the wine, demi-glace, pinch of salt, reduce, that's the word I was looking for. Cook until liquid is reduced, slightly thickened, 2 or 3 minutes. That's the word I was looking for. Reducing it down to where it gets thick. And butter burns pretty easy. That's why I think they always have you add butter. I mean, I've added it when I was cooking before, but you don't want to cook butter too long on any type of heat because it burns, kind of like garlic will also. So polenta still sitting there looking good. The meat's sitting there kind of still simmering. And the wine and demi-glaze, I don't know how you say it, whatever, is reducing. And then when I pull this off here in a minute, I'm going to add half that. It looks like a garlic butter mixture. And then when I'm done, I'll use the rest of this Parmesan for topping. And it should look something like that. We'll see. So is this reduced down enough? That butter's gonna thicken it up. I think it is kind of reduced down enough. It's not all the way on the sides. Once I throw that butter in there, it's gonna get a little thicker. That's the only thing I might be able to add is a little spice. A little crushed red pepper in there. Spice it up. Oh yeah, look at that. Mmm. All right. Turn this off, remove it from the heat, add that butter. That should melt down pretty quick. The heat's turned off, so I still wanna melt down that butter pretty good. Man, that looks pretty good, doesn't it? You guys, if I had smell-o-vision, y'all could really smell it. Ooh. Man, that smells good. All right, let's plate it. There it is. The sirloin steak red wine mushroom. Ooh. Let's see what that bad boy tastes like. You guys said they like it better when I taste it versus. That's pretty good. Until I added a little crushed red pepper. So it's polenta with spinach. Yeah, I mean the polenta, whatever. It's all right. I'm not a huge fan of it, but it tastes pretty good with the spinach and the different things. Steak is really good. Mushrooms good. I like it. All right. Now, I wanted to cover on this. They're raising a price on me. See, I was paying, I noticed it was 60% off. So all these meals have been costing me about $9 to $10 each. Well, now I just noticed the week after next, it goes back to full price, and it's $50 per meal. So, or $25 per meal, $50 for two meals. So, if you get two servings, one meal, it's $25. So, if you get two meals with two servings, it's $50. So, I don't know if this is what I mean, would I pay $25 in a restaurant for this? I don't know. Whatever. I'm not going to continue. I'm going to cancel it because all my meals have been coming 60% off to get me into it. So anyway, we'll end that there.